This is not the time for austerity. Canada entered this crisis in the best fiscal positions of its peers, and the government is using that fiscal firepower.
Justin Trudeau's pandemic throne speech promises expansions to a wide range of COVID relief programs and a whole host of new programs in order to help Canada come out of the pandemic better than it went in.
Taken together, this is an ambitious plan for an unprecedented reality. The course of events will determine what needs to be done when. But throughout, protecting and supporting Canadians will stay the top priority.
There's a promise to extend the wage subsidy into next summer, expand the small business account, and create a new Canada recovery benefit for those who come off CERB. As part of a commitment to parents and keeping women in the workforce, the Trudeau government is also promising a national child care program, a program that could be modeled on Quebec's.
The government will make a significant, long-term, sustained investment to create a Canada-wide early learning and childcare system.
There's no price tag attached to these big promises yet, and the NDP's Jugmeet Singh has pointed out that the Liberals promised pharmacare and childcare in previous throne speeches and failed to deliver, but it's likely that these social initiatives will be enough to sway the new Democrats into propping up the minority Liberals in the face of a confidence vote.
Mr. Trudeau is taking a huge risk because he prorogued Parliament, and now he's going to come in with even more expenses. That just strikes me as doubling down. He's just saying, you know what, we're in it this far, you know, in for a penny, in for a pound, and let's just go all the way and make sure we keep the ship afloat, regardless of whose kids and grandkids and great-grandkids have to pay for it.
There's a long list of additional promises in the throne speech, including new laws to punish those who neglect seniors in care, a pledge to go after tax cheats, and a commitment to fighting systemic racism. The full transcript of the throne speech can be found on the City News website. In Ottawa, Xiaoli Li, City News.